Hi everyone, I am Sudhir Gupta, teacher in study hall, Lucknow. Welcome to my channel, School Jaisa. Support me with your like, share and subscribe. Thank you.
Continuing with the same chapter, Force and Pressure, this is the third part. Till now we have done contact forces. Now we are continuing with the non-contact forces. So what are non-contact forces? The forces in which two bodies are not in touch with each other. That is force acts, but two bodies are at some distance. So when we say the force acts, two bodies are at some distance, even when a force acts, they are called as a non-contact forces. So we are going to study three different types of the non-contact forces. First, gravitational force. Now before understanding the definition, we should understand the example. Let us take an example. I have thrown a ball vertically upward. It will start going up like this, and after reaching to a particular height, it will start coming back. So the question comes, when initially it was going up, then why it started coming back after certain height? Here the point is that the force is going to be made applicable on it. Who made the applicable force? That is Earth. That means Earth is applying a force on that body, due to which that body is started coming down. So here the force is going to be made by Earth. That means the force with which the Earth attracts the body towards itself, that is the force with which the Earth pulls everything towards itself, is called the gravitational force. Now one thing more we should understand. Let us talk about the two cars are on the road. I'm taking two cars, not very good diagram, like this. I've taken the two cars. They are moving on the road. Now before then that we should know that whenever the two bodies are there, either we talk about ourselves also or we talk about any of the two objects, gravitational force is also applicable then when two bodies are at some distance. Means whenever the two bodies are there, then also there will be a force, and that force is going to be called as the gravitational force. And that force always will be tried to pull the bodies towards each other. Now the question comes, how and what happens? So that gravitational force is directly proportional to the masses of the two bodies. And what is the mass of the two bodies? What are the masses of two bodies? It depends on it, and it also depends on the distance between them. That means if we are talking about the two cars, then this one is going to have some mass, and this car will also be having some mass. So force would be acting between them also. Now the question comes, when the force is acting between them, then when the cars which move on the road, why don't they hit each other? Why don't they collide with each other? So here the point is, at the time when you say that the force acts between those two cars, then there is another force also acting vertically downward on this car. And that force is the force which is due to that of this Earth. So although the two cars are applying the force on each other, but at the same time Earth is also applying the force on this car as well as on this car. And this force which is going to be applied on the cars are much more than that of the force which is acting between two cars. How much? That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This much times greater force acts. That means Earth which is applying the force on these two cars are this much time greater than that of the force which is going to be made applicable between the two cars. So this is the reason they do not collide, they do not hit at the time when they are smoothly running on the road. So in this way we understood gravitational force is the force with which the earth pulls everything towards itself. Now we come to next call as a magnetic force. What magnetic force? It comes from the name, that is magnet. So here if I say that this is a magnet having the two poles, north and south. If I sprinkle some of the iron filling somewhere over here, what will be my observation? What will be my observation? I will observe that some of the iron particles are going to be getting attracted towards, or you can say most of them. But you will also observe that some are not going to attract it, like this one, this one, this one, this one, this one. Now the question comes, why some are going to be getting attracted? Not all. So we will understand the reason. Because whenever you talk about the magnet, then the magnet is going to have a region around it, area around it. That region is called the magnetic field. So if any magnetic substance, so here we should keep it over our mind that we should not always think that iron is only the substance which is going to be attracted by the magnet. No, not only iron, nickel and cobalt are also the substances which can be getting attracted by the magnet. So these all three we are considering right now are the magnetic substances. When they are magnetic substances, so if they are going to be lying in that particular region which is called magnetic field, they will be getting attracted towards it. So when they are going to be getting attracted towards it, why they are getting attracted towards it? Is there any force acting on it? Yes, a force is going to be acting on these particles. What is that force? Who is applying that force? That force is going to be applicable on it by the magnet, due to which it is called as a magnetic force. Here we see what? That the two bodies, that is one magnet and the another is iron filling or the nickel pieces or the cobalt pieces, they are not near to each other, they are not touching each other, they are at some distance. So when they are at some distance, even then a force is acting between them, and due to which they are coming closer, they are sticking to each other. What it tells us, this is a non-contact force. And specifically we should know one more thing, that this kind of the force is also called as a force at a distance. And one more thing, magnetic force is of the two nature, that is attractive as well as repulsive. If I take the two magnet only, suppose that I have taken a two magnet in which we observe the north and south is like this and north and south are like this, then these two magnet will also apply the force on each other, and that force which is made applicable over here is the attractive one. Why is it the attractive one? Because here two different poles are near to each other. Whereas when we take the two magnet, one is north south pole over here, then another I take it like this, that the south is here and north is here, or we take like this also, south is here, north is here, then north is here, south is here. So in these cases, what do we observe? That here the two poles are going to be of the similar nature, two similar poles are there, here also two similar poles are there, and when similar poles are there, then they will not attract, they will repel. That means there will be a repulsive force. So the force which is exerted by the magnet is called the magnetic force. Now we come to the next, which is called electrostatic force. Now we have to understand the electrostatic force. Let us take an example once more. Suppose we took a scale, a comb, and we rub it on the dry hair. Don't look at me because I don't have hairs. When we talk about the comb or the scale And when we rub it on the dry hair, what we observe? As soon as we bring that scale or the comb near to the bits of paper, suppose that the bits of paper are lying on the ground or on the table or somewhere, and when you bring this scale near to it, when after rubbing on the dry hair, we will see that it go and stick to it. It go and stick to it. Now the question comes, why do they stick to it? Is there any force acting on it? Yes, the force is acting on it. What is that force? That is called electrostatic force. Why that force is there? How is that happening? So firstly, we should know, when we have rubbed this scale on the dry hair, then due to friction, a charge has been developed on the end of the scale which is rubbed with that of the dry hair. So the charge when developed on this end, either the charge can be positive or negative. If the positive charge would have been developed on this scale, then later on when we bring it near to the widths of paper, we will observe that it stick to it. Why do they stick to it? Because when the positively charged scale was brought near to the bits of paper, automatically with a phenomena called, which we don't have to study in this class, called induced magnetism. And due to that induced magnetism, a opposite charge develops on this paper, on these papers. And due to the development of opposite charge, that is, if the positively charged scale is coming towards near to that of the bits of paper, then negative charge will develop on it. If negatively charged area or the plate or the sample is coming near to it, the opposite charge, that is positive, will develop on it. And due to that opposite charge, they will attract each other, and this is the reason that the bits of paper are going to stick with the scale. So in this way, the force which is acting, again we observe that the two bodies were not in touch with each other. Which two bodies? Bits of paper and the scale. Even when a force was acting, so this can also be called as a non-contact forces. So in all, we have studied that the non-contact forces, the gravitational force in which earth attracts each and everything towards itself, that is, I told you, whenever you are throwing something vertically upward, it comes down. Why? Because earth attracts each everything towards itself. Why? Because earth is applying a kind of force on it, and due to which it is pulling it down, it is coming down. When we talked about the magnetic, that I've already explained, magnetic force is then whenever the magnet is applying a kind of force on magnetic substance, then a force which acts is called the magnetic force. And the last, the electrostatic force, whenever the force is going to be made applicable by a charged body, then that force is going to be called as a electrostatic force. I hope this much would have been clear to you all. Thank you.